Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome to the Christmas Room.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
I just made the video yesterday of saying that was Nikon going to go out of business or not? And in today's mail, I got this really cool package from Nikon. Here, I'll show it to you. There it is. See? All right, so let's see what Nikon sent me. Why did they send me? Did they know I was making that video? Was it mental telepathy? Of course not. All right, so it's a very nice package. On the front, it's got the label. It's black. It's kind of like a black, not matte laminate, but like a... It's a subdued, it's not high gloss, it's like semi-gloss, but even a little bit lower than semi-gloss. So on this side, it says Nikon NPS, which I'm a part of, which would be like Canon CPS. And it's rounded, like in that type of a shape, flat on this side. It's like a pillow box, it's exactly what it is. So let's see what it is. I did open it and sneak, okay, so you know. But I'm gonna act surprised, okay? Surprise! So they sent me this, and they sent me this. So this is a Nikon NPS member pin. Isn't that really cool? That is a very nice looking pin. And they sent me this, it looks like a, it's a notepad. Ah, but inside, it's got a century of innovation. So inside, oh, we got a little postcard here. It's not a postcard. It's just got over 40 years of supporting imaging, professional services. This is tying 100 years of appreciation to the next 100 years. Nikon celebrates a centennial anniversary. Now, isn't that really cool? So this book is nice. It's like a notepad. They give you a pen, and it's imprinted with the Nikon logo on it. We'll find out in a second if it writes. But here, this is interesting. Look at this, and I can't read upside down, but I will show you where it's got 1, 2. Four pages of cameras, and they're dated by years. So if we start from the first year, the first cameras were rangefinders in 1948. I remember 1948. I'm just kidding. I wasn't born in 1948. So they had a Nikon rangefinder called the Nikon 1. Then in 1949, they had the Nikon M. In 1950, they had the Nikon S. In 1954, they had the S2. Then it goes to 57, 58. And then in 1963, they have the first Nikonos cameras. So in 63, 68, 75, and 80, they had the Nikonos Calypso, the Nikonos 2, the Nikonos 3, and the Nikonos 4-A. Then in 84, we have another Nikonos, and in 93, we have a Nikonos, and I guess 1983, the RS is the last one that they made. Then we start with the SLR cameras in 1959, and then it goes through here, and it shows all these really cool cameras. I don't know how much of it you could see, so I'll show you right there, and then we'll come into the modern age, which is the newest ones, which is right here. So I remember I said in the yesterday's video, the D3X, no, the D3, which was it was really a bomb, that it landed a bomb. It's not even on this page. The Nikon D3 came out in 2007. I think I said 2008 or 2009. So in 2007, I bought me a D3. Now from there, I have owned the D3. I've owned the D3X, the D700, I have to turn the page, the D7000, the 7100, the D800, and I believe the last one I had was the D800, and after, and what's current now is the D5. So the rest of it is just like really nice paper where I can make notes. So that's the little gift that Nikon NPS sent to me. And let's see, I'm going to put my name on here, Peter Gregg. And there we go. The pen writes first time. It's got a little rubber thing on the bottom here. Very nice little pen. So they give me a pen, a notepad, kind of like if you were going to get a seminar or something, or if there was a new camera with dual pixel focus coming out with Nikon, you needed to take notes. And then it's got this little strap that goes around it. It's ring bound. Very nice. So thank you, Nikon, for this wonderful gift, for this wonderful pin. I guess you could put this pin on your jacket, or I can even put it on my shirt. I'm not a pin kind of guy, to be honest with you. I don't even like wearing ties. I mean, I want to know who invented ties. Who took all of the male population and put a rope around their neck that you tie and you have it there? So anybody can just grab that tie and you now have control of that guy. Come on, who invented that? You know, it's like crazy. It's like stupid crazy. And we all wear them. We wear them to work. And we don't touch anyone's tie. But I assure you, if we get into a fight, that's the first thing I'm going for, is that tie and maybe other parts. So this is a very nice pillow box. Very impressive. This was in the mailbox. Thank you very much, Nikon. They started their 100-year celebration. And at the end of this month, they're supposed to come out with a camera that everyone is expecting to be the 820. And of course, we want to know what the speculation of the specs are. The spec speculation is already started. Are they going to spring some kind of a major surprise like they did in 2007 when they turned the whole world on its heels with the introduction of the D3? Is that going to repeat itself? I say yes. You know what? I made a little comment the other day on my last video. Actually, it was yesterday. That I think that Nikon's coming out with dual pixel focus. And people are going, where does he get that from? All right. And I suggested that maybe you ought to look up on the internet. Well, do a search for Nikon dual pixel focus. And you're going to see that there's a patent that Nikon has filed in February of this year of things that look like it's a dual focus system for their sensor. Voila! All right, so I wasn't just like pulling things out of my hat. I'm thinking like, wait a minute. This happened once before when Nikon came out of the blue and just shocked the camera nation. So now are they going to do it again? I say yes. Now, I'm not picking the timing. That's like the return of Jesus. If you pick a day, everybody's going to call you a screwball, right? So just like the return of Nikon to the forefront, if I pick a day, they're going to call me a screwball. So I don't know if it's something new. They did file a patent, so there's something that's being worked on. Is it going to be a huge surprise now? Is it going to be a mirrorless camera? So the 100-year anniversary is this month. I believe it's July 25th. Which would mean they're going to have a big to-do. So if you're a rumor site watcher, now's the time to start watching the Nikon rumors, because it's going to get exciting. And of course, it could be a big letdown. I have had that happen to me so many times. I'm waiting and expecting and expecting and waiting. And just when I think that Canon is not going to have 4K in their cameras, they're going to spring it on us. So just when I think that Nikon is not doing anything but playing to their base, I think they're going to spring out like Tigger, and boom, they're going to hit you, and boom, they're going to hit you from both sides. So that's it. That's today's end of the roll. What is the end of the roll? The gift? Just end of roll is a recap. I got the gift. I did the video yesterday on the speculation and my own speculation that Nikon will spring something forward, and that's about it. I was going through some of the older pictures, and I think I'm going to make a video just highlighting some pictures over the last 15 years of stuff that I've done with digital photography. And if I'm smart, I'll show the picture and show the camera, and name the camera that I took it with. Because I think if I was watching you and you made a video and it showed pictures from 2000 till now, I think I would like to know, well, what camera did you take that with? So I hope I'm smart enough to do that. So somebody remind me, please. All right, that's the end of the roll. Catch you later. Bye-bye. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Bye-bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching. Description of all equipment used in this video plus any notes Peter took while filming are always placed in the description box, show more box, or down arrow thingy next to the title on mobile apps. Duly noted.